Hello students, this time we will learn about the second functions of management after planning. This is organization and relates with its organizing function. When we define this term, we can say organization is a harmonious adjustment of specialized parts or the accomplishment of some common purpose but here is the some characteristics of its concept. This is here. The organization word originates from the word organism, which means a structure with its part so integrated that their relation to each other is governed by their relation to the whole. It means any organizations, the two important ingredients are first one parts and second their relationship with one another and with the organization as a whole. The parts consist of human and physical resources, as for example men, money, material, machines and methods, and second part of it, ingredients of organizations, is their relationship with one another, between individual to others, between an individual and his group, so an organization can accomplish its objectives only when its different parts are effectively integrated and united. Now we will define here the process of defining and grouping activities and establishing authority relationship among them is called organizing. Means we have to study the whole work which are necessary to accomplish our objectives. This whole process divided into similar group of works and then the group of works is departmentalized and give assignment to whole employees from top level to bottom level management. To give the responsibility and accountability to whole, that's why no one can interfere other works. So now we will see here the steps in the process of organizing in any business institution. First, we have to identify the whole activities done inside the organization and outside the organization too, and divide all of these activities, means work. And then we have to departmentalize it and make a departmental head. As a manager, and the assistants of managers, means subordinates, and assignment of duties to all. Later on, we will establish a reporting relationship here, means who will report to whom. It is clear in an organization through establishing reporting relationship. It will be maintained through a scalar chains models, which is given by Henry Fayol. After this, we will observe here the importance of this process, organizing process. First one here, the benefits of specialization. When we establish the departmentation of whole work, then each department will work with systematic allocations of the job, it will give them specializations of their work, because they will do again and again same nature of job. That's why they will gain the benefits of specialization, and their performance for a particular job of work will be enriched and effective too. And second importance of this organizing function is, when any organization adopts this function, there is clarity in working relationship between employees. Due to the assignment of job is distributed for each and individual's person in the organization, that's why they all know about their own work. And they know the hierarchy of fixation of responsibility and authority, who is senior and who is subordinate, they all know about it very clearly. Third one benefits here, optimum utilization of resources, because each employee from top to bottom in the organization, they all know their own work and responsibility too. So its benefit has come in the favor of utilizing the resources very adequately and efficiently, and it will produce the cost-effective production. Because there is nothing damage, or you can say the wastage of resources. That's why the use of present resource comes effectively and utilization of the resources is maximum. When any organization adopt this organizing process. Next importance of this process is adaptation to change. This process of organizing allows a business enterprise to accommodate change in the business environment. It will also provide much needed stability to the enterprise, as it can continue to survive and grow in spite of various changes. Next importance, effective administrations. Now, this organizing process provides a clear-cut descriptions of jobs and the related duties too. This will help to avoid any kind of confusion and duplication of work. And there is also clarity in working relationship. It will help to proper execution of work. Next, development of personnel. See, when any organization opts this function, there is a great importance of development, growth of personnel. Because there is effective delegations allows the managers to reduce their workload by assigning routine jobs to their subordinates. So the reducing of the workload maintained by subordinates this process provides the development of a skill, knowledge, efficiency, and good worthiness for their organizations. And it will help the expansion of organizations and the growth of organizations. Now in next video, we will discuss the organizational structure. Thank you.